The bakers of Weber's Bread present your all-star Western theater.
Drifting along.
Comes your all-star Western theater, starring America's great Western singers, Boy Willing and the Riders of the Purple Sage. Our guest today is that famous queen of the Western screen, Miss Dale Evans. My name is Cottonseed Clark, and here are the Riders of the Purple Sage.
Sad and Tony and Tonio, Hawthorne or Coney ran away with Tony. If you see her, just let me know, and I'll meet you in San Antonio.
Just as the moon was peeping o'er the hill,
just as the work was through,
there sat a cowboy and his partner Bill.
Cowboy was feeling blue.
Don't mind your old gal, I know she's cold, pal, if what you say is true. Come down to town, pal, down into town, pal, good time for me and you.
Where is she now, Bill cried. Cowboy just replied, San Antonio, Antonio, I'm told her pony ran away with Tony. If you see her, just let me know, and I'll meet you in San Antonio.
A cowgirl had to be mighty sharp in the days when cattle ranching and lawlessness flourished side by side in the great Southwest. She had to be ready to do a man's work at an instant's notice. In addition to her ordinary household chores, her day might include hours of riding horseback or helping to defend the herd or the ranch from Indians or desperados. Yes, our great-grandmothers really worked hard, but they always took time out to see that their menfolks had good food, just like the wives and mothers do today. That's one reason why Weber's Bread is so very popular with Southern California families. Because modern housewives know that Weber's Bread is good food. Weber's is known for its consistent quality, flavor, and freshness. When you serve Weber's Bread as toast in the morning, sandwiches at noon, or with more elaborate evening meals, you can be sure the entire family is getting added enjoyment from the menu. Buy a loaf of Weber's Bread.
On behalf of all of you All-Star Western Theater listeners today, we're happy to welcome a return visit from America's Queen of the Western screen, Miss Dale Evans. As the leading lady of that great king of the cowboys, Roy Rogers, Miss Evans has won for herself millions of fans and admirers all over the world, and a position in the field of Western entertainment achieved by no other feminine star. On the air, she has been your favorite singing star on such great programs as the Durante Moore Show, the Edgar Bergen Charlie McCarthy Show, and many others. And now, as the star of the forthcoming Roy Rogers program. And here she is in a story of the musical West prepared especially for her, entitled Dude Ranch Serenade. Friends and neighbors, sweet and lovely Miss Dale Evans. For several weeks, J.P. Cross has been making an effort to find a buyer for his Nevada Cross Bar Ranch. You see, things haven't been going so well at the ranch. It's been a mighty hot year and the water supply is very low. The sun has done a scorching job on the pasture land and the cattle are poor as a snake. Cross himself lives in Los Angeles, but the affairs of the ranch are in the capable hands of Gil Jones, better known as Jonesy. Suppose we look in on Jonesy and the ranch hands. Perhaps we'll find out just how bad things really are. It's the end of another hot work day, and they're all lazily discussing furniture.
If I was an old man Cross's shoes, I'd unload this layout on one of them smart Hollywood fellows who wants to call himself a rancher.
You can say that again. There ain't enough good grass on this place to chink the cracks between the ribs of a sandfly, much less feed a herd of cattle.
Yeah!
Well, what's
That's
so funny
right.
about that?
Oh, I was just a-thinking.
Thinking? That's an unusual sport for you to be taking part in, isn't it?
Oh, I ain't so dumb.
Top, what was you thinking?
Well, last year it rained so much everybody was a-wishing they'd growed fins instead of feet, and all of you was complaining about it. And this year it's hot enough to slip hair on a bear, and you're complaining about that. Now, my question is, what do you want, rain or shine?
Just a little bit of each, Pop. Enough for a happy medium.
Well, then you better start paying the preacher a little more regular-like.
Say, here comes old Thad Gilbert.
Well, howdy, Thad. Get off your horse and sit a while.
Haven't got time, Jonesy. Got a telegram here for you.
All right, Thad. Much obliged to you.
Say, maybe somebody's dead.
See you later, boy.
Hello. Goodbye, Thad. Goodbye. I wonder who'd be sending us a telegram.
Must be from old man Cross.
Hope he don't want me to come into Los Angeles again.
Well, come on, Jonesy. What does it say?
Boys, I'm afraid I got some bad news.
Well, quit talking here and let's hear about it.
Well, we've all been sticking it out here because of our loyalty to old man Cross. Hoping that he'd sell so we'd have an opportunity to dig us a new hole somewhere.
So what's happened?
Here, I'll read this telegram. The Solar Ranch. New owner insists that you boys stay on the job and help convert the Cross Bar into a dude ranch. Sorry, I had to include you men in on the deal.
Why, that dirty double-crossing old rat. After all we've done for him.
Yeah, if he thinks he's going to make a dude rancher out of me, he's crazy.
Wait. Here's the worst part. Your new boss will arrive at the Cross Bar tomorrow morning. She is Miss Judy Gale, the radio singer.
Judy Gale?
Are you kidding?
Let me see that telegram.
Well, what's all the excitement?
Well, she's just about the biggest thing in star in the Western business, that's all.
And what in the care hat has that got to do with this ranch and you men?
Plenty.
Well, you said yourself we had the best singing act that you ever heard.
And that we ought to be on the radio.
And you figure Judy Gale will give you that chance?
Why not? If she hears us and likes us, well, she's big enough to do anything she likes.
Well, I'm against it. Ranching will always be here, but radio is just one of them passing fancies or something or other.
Jimmy, you go get the guitar. We got some rehearsing to do. Now, look, boy, she ought to be driving up most any time. Now, leave everything to me, and before night comes on, I'll talk her into giving us one of them, whatchamacallit?
Audition.
Yeah, audition. And after she hears us, she'll send that Tex Lopez and his line riders back to the farm.
Hey, yonder comes Jonesy. He's still mad.
Yeah, I think I got a way to win Jonesy over.
Say, now, let's just perform one miracle at a time.
Now, look here, boys. You better not start in on that singing business with this gal. In the first place, it's all a lot of nonsense. And in the second place...
You know, Jonesy, since this radio business came up, I've been thinking about something.
It's about time you started thinking.
With a voice like yours, it wouldn't surprise me at all that you'd make a heck of a good radio announcer.
I wouldn't because... What'd you say?
Oh, well, I've been listening to you talk here late.
You have?
I've compared you with a lot of them fellas on the radio. And you're as good as any of them.
Well, now, you know, I might be a pretty good announcer at that.
Yes, sir. And if I was you, I'd play up to Miss Judy. She might be able to swing a big deal for you.
By golly, you're right. I'll watch my talking.
Yonder she comes.
Oh, boy. Now, look. Now, remember, man. Leave it to me. When the right time comes, I'll proposition her about that audition.
Well... Miss Gale? Miss Gale, on behalf of me and the boys, and through the courtesy of the Cross Bar Ranch, welcome.
Hello, boys. Gee, I didn't expect such a nice welcome.
Well, it's the least we could do. This is Gil Jones speaking.
I'm glad to know you, Mr. Jones.
Oh, just call me Jonesy. These are the boys, Miss Judy, Lopi, Jimmy, and Johnny.
Well, it's nice to know you boys, and I'm sure we'll all get along just wonderful.
My name is Top, Miss Judy. I do the cooking.
Then I know we'll get along fine.
I've got a great big meal ready to serve you.
And I'm just hungry enough to eat it all.
We'll bring your things in, Miss Judy.
Thank you.
Take you long to make the drive down from Hollywood?
Well, let's see. I left there at 7 this morning, and it's now...
The correct time is now 12:35, courtesy of Gil Jones. Spell T-I-M-E.
Miss Judy, do you plan to go back to Hollywood this weekend for your radio program?
No, I thought perhaps there'd be so much to do getting ready to open my dude ranch that I'd better stay here. So I transcribe my program. It'll be played by record at the regular time.
Do you mean we'll be sitting here with you, listening to you, sing to you from Hollywood?
Something like that, Pop.
What are your plans about the ranch, Miss Judy?
Well, first, boys, I want to sell what cattle I got for my deal with Mr. Cross.
Uh-huh.
Then we'll modernize the place. We'll get a good stock of gentle saddle horses, and we'll build some additional accommodations for the guests, And in the meantime, we'll start advertising our grand opening on the radio and in the newspapers.
I reckon you'll be running back and forth to Hollywood a lot trying to keep your radio program going.
No, Lopey, beginning 3 weeks from this Saturday, my broadcast will originate right here at the Cross Bar.
Are you kidding?
I am not.
Well,
that will be the day of our grand opening. We'll have enough guests, I hope, to make up an audience, and I'll have the line riders and my announcer and engineer drive down each weekend. Say, by the way, boys, how do you like my program?
Oh, you're great, Miss Judy.
Yeah, everybody knows you're about the best Western singer in the country.
Oh, you're just nice, fellas. I want to ask you something. What do you think of Tex Lopez and the line riders?
Well, to tell the truth, Miss Judy, they're not strong enough to support a star like you.
And personally, Miss Judy, I think your announcer, Clark Cotton, stinks.
Why, boys, I'm surprised to hear you say that. The listeners seem to think they're all grand.
Now, you take us, Miss Judy. We sing the kind of music that would do justice to a big star like you.
Sure. Oh, I see. You boys sing.
Do we sing?
Well, sure we sing. You see, Miss Judy, we figured if you would give us an audition, well, maybe we could...
Look, boys, I've only been here about an hour, but I've already taken a great liking for all of you. And I know we're all going to get along just fine, but suppose we forget about wanting to sing.
But, Miss Judy, we've...
Lopey, all of you, my sponsor is very happy with the line writers. If I heard you sing, I'd have to tell you no, and that would hurt your feelings. And, well, fellow singers need experience, and you boys are cowhands. So, please, don't ask me to listen to you, will you? I'd like to be your friend.
Well, Miss Judy's been here 3 days, and we ain't no better off than before she came as far as radio is concerned.
Now, look, I've got an idea. Take my advice, and we'll be on that first broadcast from the Cross Bar.
Now you're talking in riddles.
But look, don't mention singing around her anymore. I'll let you know my plan in plenty of time.
Say, Miss Judy's program is on from Hollywood at 7 o'clock. We don't want to miss that.
Hurry up, Top. Get that wire plugged in at 7 o'clock. We don't want to miss any of Miss Judy's program.
Just leave it to old Top. I'll get it.
Gosh, Miss Judy, here we are with you fixing to listen to your radio program. I bet there's a million people who'd like to be doing the same thing.
Jimmy, you embarrass me. I'm the one who's proud to be here with you boys. After all, maybe I'm not as good as you think I am, and you can tell me how to improve some.
Well, what are you going to sing on your first program?
It's a new song written by Roy Rogers and Dale Evans called My Heart Went That-A-Way. It's a cute song, and Roy made a wonderful recording of it, but Dale, well, frankly, I don't care so much for her.
Oh, no, you sing much better than she does, Miss Judy.
Thank you, Lopey.
She's all ready, folks.
Then turn it on, Top. It's 7 o'clock.
Right on the nose.
Now, everybody be quiet. We don't want to miss nothing.
Hello there, friends and neighbors. This is Clark Cotton bringing you America's Queen of the West, Miss Judy Gale, and here she is.
Hello, folks. It's good to be with you again tonight. I'd like to start my program with a brand new song written by Roy Rogers and Dale Evans entitled My Heart Went That-A-Way. You know, I was on their set out at Republic the other day, and they told me how they came to write it. It seems so many of the cowboys use that expression, they went that-a-way, that Roy and Dale thought it might make a good song. That is, if they added a little romantic flavor. They came up with the title My Heart Went That-A-Way, and an hour and a half later, they'd finished it. And I hope you like it.
Gosh, that announcer stinks.
Shut up, Jones, unless you're Miss Judy sing.
Isn't that important, boys? I went to town to look around and hit the old tie. But when I saw you passing by, my heart went that away. Now you know why, and so do I almost went astray. But when I saw you passing by, my heart went that away. Look at me, I used to be a roaming all around. But today you came my way, guess I'll have to settle down. There's not a thing that I can do or nothing you can say. But when I saw you passing by, my heart went that away. Now lots of boys are very nice, I meet them every day. But when I saw you passing by, my heart went that away. I knew a boy when I was young, I loved him till today. But when I saw you passing by, my heart went that away. Look
to be a roaming all around. But you passed by, I caught your eye. I want to settle down. There's not a thing that I can do or nothing you can say. 'Cause when I saw you passing by, my heart went that away.
Well, Miss Judy, we've done a lot of work around here the past 3 weeks.
Yeah, and we're all ready for the big broadcast tomorrow.
Oh, you boys have been grand. You know, if our dude ranch is a big success, I'll owe it all to you.
Oh, shucks, Miss Judy, you're just a-saying that.
Say, when do you expect Tex Lopez and his line riders?
Well, they'll come down in the morning. Mel Noah, our engineer, will get here this afternoon and get all the technical equipment ready. Bob Struble, the producer, is here now.
Anyway, we can help, just let us know, Miss Judy.
Oh, that's nice of the Jonesy, thanks.
That's our ring top. Better answer it.
Don't forget the chairs, boys.
Course, boys.
Don't worry about a thing,
start
Miss
talking.
Judy.
Los Angeles? Just a minute. Miss Judy, it's long distance for you.
Good. Perhaps that's the radio station calling. Hello? Hello, Clark? Oh, splendid. Everything's in order here. Listen, you boys have your numbers well rehearsed. Then when you get here, all we'll have to do is run a timing and we'll be ready for the air. Good. Make it as early as possible, will you? All right, goodbye.
Is everything in order, Miss Judy?
Oh, fine. Clark Cotton and the boys won't be able to be here until about 2 hours before airtime, but that'll be all right. They have a show in Hollywood in the morning.
Do they know what road to take? You know, it's mighty easy to get lost in these parts.
Well, I wrote them the instructions. I told them to take Canyon Road after they left the highway, and it would bring them right to our door. Hey, by the way, how are our reservations?
Sold out, Miss Judy. We'll have the place overflown with dudes by noon tomorrow.
That's wonderful.
Jimmy, you and Johnny come with me. I've got a job for you.
Okay.
Now, look, here's what I want to do.
Well, never mind what you want us to do. That broadcast comes off tomorrow, and you promised us you had a plan all figured out. Now, what is it?
Yeah, what about it? Well, just keep your shirt on. That's what I'm coming to. Now, look, I want you and Jimmy to take the truck about noon tomorrow and drive down to Canyon Crossroads.
Are you crazy?
Now, wait a minute. Listen, I want you to park right there at the crossroads and wait.
Now, look here, Lopey.
Well, let me finish. I want you to wait there until you see that radio gang of Miss Judy's heading this way.
Yeah, and escort them back to the ranch. I quit.
Oh, if you don't shut up and listen, I'm going to hit you with an axe handle. Now, look. Take down the sign with the directions on it. They're bound to stop and ask how to get to the crossbar and which road to take. I want you to send them on the doggonedest wild goose chase they ever went on.
Well, it's 3 o'clock, and according to Miss Judy, they'll be here at the ranch about 4.
And that's about an hour's drive from here.
Yeah, I hate to think what's going to happen if this don't work out.
Look, here comes a car.
By golly, I believe that's them.
They're slowing up. They see this crossroad.
Yeah, this will confuse anybody. That's putting a sign down.
You do the talking. I got a little religion, and I don't want to lose it by telling them such a lie.
Yeah, just leave it to me.
Say, I wonder if you men could tow us into town.
Sorry, old boy, we haven't got time. Say, we're in a big hurry to make a broadcast. Which of these roads do we take to reach the Crossbar Ranch?
Are you kidding, friend?
Why, no. What do you mean, am I kidding?
Why, you're on the wrong road to the Crossbar Ranch.
The wrong road? Did you hear that, guys? Oh, tell us, how do we get there?
Well, you could go back to the main highway where you turned off about 75 miles back.
But, Miss Judy, baby, they'll drive in most any minute.
Are you kidding? It's 5 minutes till airtime. What am I going to do? No music, no announcer, no singers?
Miss Judy, we'll be glad to help you. I play guitar and...
Oh, that's impossible, boys. You couldn't possibly do it. And think of all our Dude Ranch customers who are expecting to see this broadcast.
But I'm telling you, Miss Judy, we can do it. We have a guitar, a bass fiddle, and an accordion, a clarinet, and a piccolo.
Just wait till I get my hands on that Clark Cotton and that Tex Lopez. I'll wring their necks like a chicken.
Well, Miss Judy, we're better than nothing at all.
Yeah, and it's almost airtime. Our instruments are all tuned up and ready to go.
I don't even have an announcer.
I beg your pardon.
Uh-oh.
Oh, not you, Jonesy. Well,
I swiped that script of yours last night, and I've memorized every line of it.
Oh, dearie, it's about that time. Shall I talk to Hollywood on the line and cancel out?
And ruin everything after I've advertised this thing for 3 weeks to the Four Corners? Not much. Grab those instruments,
oh,
boys.
Boy.
Here's a script, Jonesy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
We're going to do an air show if it kills me and the listeners, too.
Oh, baby, that's
what's your first number, Miss Judy?
Nobody's darling but mine in the key of, let me see, E flat.
Don't worry, Miss Judy. We'll make it good.
Thank you. Just do your best, boys. What else can we do? Now, come on, let's go to the broadcast room. Everybody's waiting. Ladies and gentlemen, we're sorry to have kept you waiting right up to broadcast time, but we've had some difficulties on our first broadcast, which we will not undertake to explain at this time. It's now only a few seconds to go, and we'll ask you to be quiet, please. And throughout the broadcast, remember to follow the instructions of our announcer, Mr.
Gil Jones, folks.
Mr. Gil Jones. Jonesy, please be a good announcer. Just this one.
It's in the bag, Miss Judy.
5 seconds. Quiet, please.
From the famous Crossbar Dude Ranch in Nevada comes America's Queen of the West, Miss Judy Gale. And here she is.
Thank you, Jonesy, and hello, folks. It's good to be with you again tonight. We're broadcasting our program from my new Dude Ranch in Nevada, where we hope to be seeing you real soon. To get things underway on our first Dude Ranch broadcast, I'm going to ask some of my ranch hands, Lopie Willingham and his boys, to join me in an old favorite of yours, Nobody's Darling But Mine. Come sit by my side, little darling. Come lay your cool hand on my brow. Darling, but mine.
You're as sweet as the flowers of springtime. You're as pure as the dew from the rose. I had rather be somebody's darling than a poor boy that nobody knows.
Nobody's darling but mine, love. Be honest, be faithful, be true. Promise me that you will never. Program for this week. We hope you'll all be back with us again next Saturday night. And until then, this is Judy Gale saying so long and goodbye to you all.
Join us again next week at the same time when you will hear America's Queen of the West, Miss Judy Gale. This is Gil Jones speaking.
All right, you're off the air. Oh, Miss Judy.
Yes, Bob.
Your sponsor's on the broadcast line and wants to talk with you.
Oh, all right. Here goes, boys.
How'd we do, Miss Judy?
Oh, I know you did grand, boys, but I was numb from the moment we hit the air. We'll know in a minute. The sponsor's on the wire.
We're just talking to the microphone, whose voice will come through the loudspeaker.
Well, here it comes. Hello, Mr. Nat Seeger.
Judy, where's Clark Cotton and that gang of no-good musicians?
They didn't show up for the broadcast, Roy.
Who was that crew of hillbillies you had playing and singing for you?
Well, they were some of our ranch hands.
What? Then put them under contract. Don't let them get away. They're the best I ever heard.
What do you like? We're the best
we ever heard. Fee likes them very much, too. Now, she's going to pick up Kilpatrick in San Francisco and bring him down to the broadcast next week.
Oh, I'm so glad you like them.
Hey, that's the best show you ever put on. I'm doubling your salary and another year's contract. And who's that announcer?
My ranch foreman, Gil Jonesy.
Then beginning right now, he's got a steady job. Ooh, I'll be down in a few days to see you. Goodbye.
Well, boys, what do you know about that?
Oh, get some water, quick, boys. Miss Judy's fainted. Get some water.
Thank you, Miss Dale Evans, for a return visit to the All-Star Western Theater. Our guest star will return in a few moments, friends and neighbors.
Life wasn't easy in the days when men were fighting each other and the elements to carve a home from the rough and ready frontiers. And history is rich in the many stories of the heroic women who helped to bring the spirit of homemaking to the lawless Old West. The development of the great cattle country would have taken a lot longer if it hadn't been for the women who stood staunchly by the side of their men, who endured hardships to build homes and raise families. That tradition has been handed down to the women of today, too. It is still a woman's task to be the home builder, to see that her family has the proper care and plenty of good food. And that includes plenty of Weber's bread, because Weber's bread is good food. With its firm, even texture, golden brown crust, and appetizing flavor, Weber's bread adds extra enjoyment to every meal. Remember Weber's bread in the blue gingham wrapper.
And now, here is Foy Willing with our grand guest star, Miss Dale Evans.
Dale, you're about the nicest thing that has ever happened to our All-Star Western Theater, and we want to thank you for taking time out from a busy Republic Picture schedule to visit with us once again.
Boy, it's always nice visiting with my friends, and all of you Western Theater boys are really my friends. But let's get on to business. How about another song from the writers of the Purple Sage?
All right, Dale. I think maybe the folks would like to hear To Each His Own.
Mm-hmm. We'd love it.
A rose must remain with the sun and the rain, or its lovely promise won't come true. To each his own, to each his own, and my own is you. What good is a song if the words don't belong? And a dream must be a dream for two. No good alone to each his own. For me there's you. If a flame is to grow, there must be a glow. To open each door, there's a key. I need you, I know, I can't let you go. Your touch means too much to me.
To lips must insist on two more to be kissed, or they'll never know what love can do.
From Hollywood, you've heard your All-Star Western Theater, a V.M. Bear production starring America's great Western singers, Foy Willing and the Riders of the Purple Sage. Our guest star today has been that queen of the Western screen, Miss Dale Evans, whose latest Republic picture with Roy Rogers is My Pal Trigger. My name is Cottonseed Clark.
This program came to you from the studios of KMX, Columbia Square.